Excellencies, delegates, representatives of the United Nations, colleagues from civil society, academia, and local authority, private sector, and other groups. It is essential that Africa tells its own story about the development it wants to see in Africa and globally post-2015. I'm humbled by this chance to tell to you a part of the African story. I will therefore tell you about the lessons I have learned from the African people. My presentation is a consolidation of the perspectives of ordinary people that were expressed through a series of participatory research works organized by participants and poverty hearings that were conducted by the African Monitor, the Global Call to Action Against Poverty, and the SEED Institute. In participate, people living in marginalization and vulnerability were supported to frame their own research questions, define appropriate methodology, and carry out visual studies amongst themselves. They were the researchers, research population, and the sample, as well as the data analysts. For the hearings conducted in Liberia, Ghana, Mozambique, Kenya, and South Africa, panels of eminent community volunteers listened to testimonials of people's experience with poverty, testimonials that were presented with dignity and honor. When grassroots communities describe their lived realities, they teach us that the development they envision is not the same as the development the majority of world imagines they want. In their own narrative, the strongest messages coming from communities is a deep desire for the capability to function. Such capacity to function, as evidenced from the data attained through the people's first-hand testimonials, was sought by the people for the sole purpose of reclaiming the power to effect decisions that affect their lives, in order to be able to access equal opportunities, and in order to have an enabling environment to sustain livelihood. In talking about the future they want, people presented a catalog of critical blockages standing between them and the aspired capacity to function. This catalog ranged from vulnerabilities, exclusion based on social norms, legal and political discrimination, corruption, insecurity, crime, inadequate skills, and lack of opportunities to own assets. Unlocking the African moment requires a removal of these blockages. Similarly, the testimonials were very clear about some of the enablers people require. They include access to information, meaningful participation, and influence in decision-making, quality and equitable education and training, and access to grassroots-focused infrastructure, quality and inclusive healthcare, access to productive assets, secure livelihoods, and other social services. Therefore, as we deliberate on the post-2015 development agenda, I recommend three things. First, a transformative agenda requires a transformative declaration, a game changer that shifts the focus from merely treating people from a point of vulnerability to involving them as active participants and the best judges of their own development. Let us not ask, what can we do for the people? But also remember to ask, what are the people doing and how can we accompany them in their local development innovations? Secondly, a transformative agenda requires goals and targets which go beyond the easy to measure and instead prioritize the hardest to do tasks, because this will make the biggest impact. And third, no goal, no target, and no indicator can achieve its ambition if it does not have a clear and effective means of implementation. We cannot continue doing the same thing the same way and expect different results. In articulating the means of implementation, take my advice. Money, partnership, and technology alone will not be sufficient. We also need to explicitly plan how to increase opportunities for people to co-create locally appropriate development agenda. And in that regard, I advise that when we talk about the means of implementation through the lens of financing technology and partnerships, this will naturally preclude people power. We therefore propose that a section of on people participation in framing the means of implementation is also added. Thank you so much.